Americans send and receive more than 5 billion text messages every single day, and we're using video and social media networks to communicate in incredible new ways. But at their core, wireless devices are fantastic safety tools. That's why the wireless industry is developing next-generation 911 technology to use our mobile devices to send text messages, pictures, and videos to 911. While we're working toward next-gen 911, many want to use wireless to send text messages to 911 right now, especially those individuals who are deaf, hard of hearing, or speech impaired. That's why AT&T, Sprint, T-Mobile, and Verizon Wireless voluntarily committed to the public safety community to make text-to-911 service available by May 15th of this year. These providers are working to make that deadline, but there are three important things you need to know before sending a text to 911. First, sending a text message to 911 doesn't work the same as calling 911. It's best to always call and only text if you can't talk, so that first responders can collect the most accurate information in the quickest way possible. Second, text to 911 will only go to local call centers that have asked providers to receive those messages. As of April 2014, emergency call centers in 14 states have asked to receive text to 911 service. Third, if you send a 911 text to a center not equipped to receive it, you'll know because all wireless carriers send a bounce back text message to tell you to call 911 instead. While the life-saving potential of text to 911 is tremendous, always try to call 911 and only text if you can't talk. First responders agree that calling 911 is still the preferred way to get help during an emergency. One issue that is critical to a 911 call center's ability to receive new types of communications is funding. Most 911 call centers get their funding from taxes and fees on your wireless and landline services bill. Unfortunately, some states are raiding the 911 funds that are collected and using that money instead to cover budget shortfalls and other unrelated programs. CTIA, its member companies, and first responders have stressed the need to prevent states from raiding the funds for these unauthorized uses. The ability to contact 911 anytime, anywhere is the number one benefit that mobile technology offers consumers. It's why more than 400,000 wireless 911 calls are made every single day. April is now National 911 Education Month. So to learn more about 911 and text to 911, visit CTIA.org.